Shalom again. Welcome back. Facebook, hey, I'm dealing with issues, technical difficulties. Hopefully everything works out. But let's get back into the Word of God. Let's go to the book of James, chapter 5, beginning at verse 1. James, chapter 5, beginning at verse 1, all the way down to verse 20. You got your Bibles? All right, let's begin. Verse 1. Go to now, ye rich men, weep and howl for the miseries that shall come upon you. All right, James wrote this epistle to the 12 tribes of Israel that are scattered. If you remember in chapter 1, he said to the 12 tribes scattered abroad. So that's who this epistle is to. That's who it's for. That's who it's about. Not to, for, and about everybody else in the whole wide world. It's to Hebrew Israelites of the seed of Abraham, of the tribe, of all the 12 tribes, but especially the tribe of Judah. Judah is the chosen tribe. That's who this scripture is about, and that's who it's to, and that's who it's for. It's not for the people over in the land called the nation of Israel. They are not God's chosen people. They are not Hebrew Israelites of the seed of Abraham. They're not of any of the tribes. They don't have any of the lineage of Abraham or any of the tribes of Judah or any of the tribes. They're Ashkenaz, Khazarians, Japhet, Gentiles, and Edomites who have taken over the land by fraud and deceit. And since 1948, everybody thinks they are God's chosen people. That's why they call themselves Jewish. They wish they were Jews, but they are not God's chosen people. God's chosen people are scattered to the four winds. That's why Jesus is coming back to gather us. Jesus didn't come to start Christianity. He didn't come to start a religion. He came to save his people from their sin, and that's who he's coming back for, okay? So that's what you have to keep in mind when you're studying the scripture. Christianity was created by Romans, and it says that Jesus came to save everybody. That's against the scripture. That's why the 501c3 corporations, pastors, preachers, and teachers of this Antichrist church system, that's why they're Antichrist, because they go against the word of God. Jesus didn't come to save everybody. He only came to save his people from their sin. And so that's what the word of God says, and that's what we have to preach and teach. And we preach the kingdom of heaven. The kingdom of heaven is for Israel, all 12 tribes. That's why it's 12 gates. And so Jesus is coming back for his people who are scattered to the four winds to gather us. He's not coming back for the rest of the world. So again, verse 1, it says, go to now, you rich men. Everybody that's rich, especially people who are Hebrew Israelites of the seed of Abraham, you trust in your riches. You got money in the bank, but gold can't save your soul. The scripture says, weep and howl for your miseries that shall come upon you. A lot of people put their trust in their money. But your money can't save you. Scripture telling you to weep and howl for the miseries that shall come upon you, because you trust in your money rather than trusting in the Lord. Verse 2, your riches are corrupted and your garments are moth-eaten. So all the money that you have is not worth a hill of beans. Jesus told a rich young ruler that he had all his money to go sell everything that he had and follow him. But he walked away sad because he had great riches. And then there was another rich man who said he had so much stuff, he was going to tear down his barns and build other bigger barns. And Jesus said, tonight, thy food, thy soul shall be required of thee. So people who put their trust in their money, you're deceived by riches. Your riches are corrupted and your garments are moth-eaten. Verse 3, your gold and silver are cankered, and the rust of them shall be a witness against you and shall eat your flesh as it were fire. I praise you, treasure together for the last days. So that's what you've been taught by the world. Get all you can get. Get it while the getting is good. And to be, you know, rich as much as you can. Get as much money. That's why everybody want to play the lottery. It ain't about the money. Jesus said your life does not consist in the abundance of things that you possess. But people get these fancy jobs and make all this money and got a big old fine house and can pay all their bills and they ain't worried about nothing, but they put their trust in their money. That's not a good thing to do. And you think you got it made, but you're not living for the kingdom of heaven. You're living for the right now. And so when the Lord comes back, he's not coming back for you because you're not putting your trust in the Lord. Verse 3 again says, your gold and silver is cankered, and the rust of them shall be a witness against you and shall eat your flesh as it were fire. So when the Lord comes back, don't look to go with him. Verse 3 again, it says, you have heaped treasure together for the last day. You think you can buy your way into heaven? You can't buy your way into heaven, no matter how much money you have. It's not enough. You got to have faith. You got to repent. You got to turn to the Lord Jesus Christ. Verse 4, behold, the hire of the laborers who have reaped down your fields, which is of you kept back by fraud, crying. The cries of them which have reaped are entered into the ears of the Lord of Sabbath. All these rich people in the world, they keep getting richer, and all the poor folks keep getting poor, living from paycheck to paycheck. And so y'all gonna have to give account for that. You hire these people, and you don't hardly pay them any money to live or survive. It says that the hire of the laborers who have reaped down your fields, which is of you kept back by fraud. You deceive, you're taking the people, just using them as game. People are just slaves, wage slaves, working from sun up to sun down. Can't hardly make enough money to survive and live. Everybody that's rich and taking advantage of people, especially who are Hebrew Israelites, you're going to have to pay for that. The cries of them which have reaped are entered into the ears of the Lord of Sabbath. The Lord knows what's going on. All your wicked deeds are before the Lord. You can't hide anything. You better repent. Verse 5, you have lived in pleasure on the earth and been wanton. You have nourished your heart as in the days of slaughter. You go on vacations 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 times out of the year. Go lay on the beach. You just got money to do anything and everything you want, all the pleasures of the world. Sit back and relax and don't have to worry about nothing. Get up when you want to. Go to bed when you want to. Drink as much as you want to. The scripture says you have lived in pleasure on the earth and been wanton. That ain't even enough. Though you have everything you could possibly want and have, it's still not enough. You have nourished your hearts as in the days of slaughter. You know, back in the day when they was getting ready to slaughter the pigs or the hogs for a festival or whatever, they fattened it up. And so that's how people are nourishing their heart, as in the day of slaughter. Just taking in everything, eating and drinking and being merry, doing exactly what they want to do. Verse 6, you have condemned and killed the just, and he doeth not resist you. The rich people, they do whatever they want. They can buy their way out of jail. They can frame somebody to take the blame for them. And the poor people don't have no justice. They can't afford a lawyer. So that's why the jails is full, especially of Hebrew Israelites, of the seed of Abraham, of the tribe of Judah here in America. We're filling the jails more than any other people in the world. That's who these jails are full of and filled with. There's no justice in the justice system in America. because we don't have the money to afford these courts and lawyers. So whatever the reason they want to put us in jail, that's why they put us in jail, because we can't afford to get ourselves out of there. Verse 7, be patient, therefore, brethren, unto the coming of the Lord. Behold, the husbandman waiteth for the precious fruit of the earth, and hath long patience for it, until he received the early and latter rain. So the Lord is coming back for us. I know it's been said a long time, but every day is a day closer. We have to continue to have faith. The scripture says, be patient until the coming of the Lord. That's why we have to preach the kingdom of heaven, because the Lord is coming back to establish his kingdom on the earth. Israel is the church. Israel is the body of Christ. That's who the Lord is coming back for, all 12 tribes. He's not coming back for everybody else.